Hello everyone, this is Cynthia Thinnes. Welcome to my channel. In the West, the Enlightenment and Scientific Revolution was devastating to astrology. Prior to that time, astrology was a respected discipline. Indeed, it was a required subject in most universities, and almost all physicians were also astrologers. In the 19th century, Ellen Leo worked to revive astrology, but by that time, much damage had already been done. And most importantly, astrology lost the living tradition that had been passed down from teacher to student for centuries, if not millennia. In the mid-1980s, Robert Schmidt and many other scholars undertook the enormous task of recovering and translating manuscripts from our lost tradition. While this work was invaluable, it also created a large rift between astrologers, and I believe created a great deal of confusion for students and for clients. There are some astrologers who are working to heal the differences, and some blend modern and traditional techniques, but there's not really a framework for this though, and so these efforts can sometimes seem almost random and haphazard. In the past several years, I've been studying essentialist philosophy. In my studies, I learned that prior to the Enlightenment, there was another break in tradition, and this break came from Aristotle. While the break in tradition was not as dramatic as the one that happened in the Enlightenment, it did leave astrology vulnerable to the discoveries that occurred in astronomy during the Renaissance and in modern times. Neither of these breaks in tradition happened in the East. Aristotelian influence can still be seen in Indian astrology, but for the most part, Jyotish is still based on traditional cosmology. Astrology is also still a respected discipline in India. Unfortunately, I do not believe that it is really possible to restore what was lost in the West. On the other hand, despite its broken tradition, I still think there is value in Western astrology. What I think we can do is to rediscover essentialist philosophy. I believe that essentialist philosophy holds the key to truly understanding traditional texts and to evaluating recent developments in astrology in a systematic way. This is what I'm trying to do with essentialist astrology. I invite you to follow along in this journey. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please give me a like. If you would like to receive notifications of new videos, please subscribe and ring the bell.